Welcome everyone. Today I wanted to talk about the staking mechanism within Cardano and why I think that it is superior to some of the other proof of stake protocols out there. So if you're familiar with Cardano, Cardano is a dynamic proof of stake cryptocurrency. There are other cryptocurrencies out there that are delegated proof of stake cryptocurrencies. I have tinkered around and experimented with many different cryptocurrencies, proof of stake cryptocurrencies, just to see how the staking mechanism works. Like you have coins out there like Cosmos, and Ethereum is going to go proof of stake as well. And why I think that this dynamic model of proof of stake is so superior to other proof of stake models is because a lot of these staking tokens out there, they have various features embedded in the protocol that makes it very difficult to remove your tokens. So if you undelegate to a pool, or if you remove your stake, there's a undelegation period or an unstaking period. It could be 3 weeks, it could be a week. Regardless of what happens, you have to literally remove your stake from whatever pool you're delegating to. And it takes, there's a lockup period. And this is very inconvenient, this long wait period, because if you're trying to get in and out of a cryptocurrency, you want to make sure that you have access to your funds immediately. And for a lot of these crypto projects out there that are proof of stake, you have to undelegate, or you have to remove your pledge, or you have to remove your delegation, and there's a waiting period before you can access your money. So it's not really autonomy of funds there, because the protocol itself is holding your tokens unless proven otherwise, or you can get your token slashed if your delegator or your person that you, or your pool that you're delegating to does not perform as expected. If it does not produce the blocks it's supposed to be producing, you could have your token slashed. None of that happens within Cardano. So if you delegate 10,000 ADA to a pool, you're not going to get slashed. You're not going to get your principal slashed if the pool operator is not performing as expected. If they do not perform, of course, you may not get rewards for a certain epoch, but your principal is not going to be affected. There could be examples where you are within a certain protocol that maybe charges a 1% slashing fee every time the operator does not produce blocks. What if you go on an extended vacation or a long leave? All of a sudden you come back and your principal has been slashed dramatically. This is not what happens within Cardano. You can jump in and you can jump out. You can undelegate at any particular time with no penalty. All that's going to start happen is you're going to stop getting rewards. Obviously, you're not staking. You're not going to be able to get rewards. So moving forward, a lot of people that are new to Cardano, you want to make sure you remember this in the next bull run, because there are going to be people out there that are going to try to get out as soon as possible. So you may have a target price that you want to get out. And it's very important for you to have the access to your tokens as quick as possible and access the liquidity pools you need to access in order to either sell your coins or you trade your coins, whatever the case may be. And I think it's extremely important for people to be able to jump in and jump out. Basically, what I'm saying is this is a very flexible cryptocurrency, and there's no hold up period. There's no lockup period. You have autonomy of your funds. There is no protocol rules in place that prevent you from accessing your money. And there shouldn't be. It's no different than the traditional monetary system. You go to a bank, it's Friday, 6 p.m., all of a sudden the bank is closed. You got to wait until Monday at 8 a.m. in order to go and talk to a teller or schedule an appointment. It's the same thing. We don't want to be delegating, or we don't want to be involved in cryptocurrencies that limit your potential or limit your growth. You want to be able to access your funds in a secure and safe manner. This is an extremely safe cryptocurrency to use. At no point do you relinquish your rights of your ADA. Delegation does not mean that the pool operator holds your ADA. You always hold your own ADA. You're just pointing it in the direction of the pool. So let me know what you think about these other proof of stake protocols, these other delegated proof of stake protocols that implement slashing, or they implement a restriction on accessing your funds. Are you in agreement with that, or are you not? Until the next video, thank you. I appreciate you, and have a wonderful week.